He was born here in Puerto Rico, became famous in the U.S., but most people don't know his story.
Sejam muito bem-vindos ao Terceira Dimensão. Neste programa vamos viajar no tempo. Segundo reza a lenda, Pedro Francisco nasceu no Porto Judeu e veio a tornar-se um herói na Revolução Americana, sob o comando de George Washington. Será o próprio descendente deste incontornável vulto que nos vai contar a história.
Na vila do Porto Judeu, em 1760, nasceu aquele que mais tarde se tornou um herói nos Estados Unidos da América. Pedro Francisco Machado ficou conhecido pelo decisivo papel que teve na Guerra da Independência da pátria onde viveu. Este vulto da história lutou lado a lado com George Washington e com o Marquês de Lafayette.
Pedro Francisco was my great-great-great-grandfather, in fact, he's my sixth generation. I'm a seventh generation descendant of Pedro Francisco. But he was born here in Puerto Rico, became famous in the U.S., but most people don't know his story. So in fact, in the U.S., there are five monuments that stand in his honor. Here in Puerto Rico, there's one. The sports arena is named after Pedro Francisco. And there's a street here in Puerto Rico in honor of him. But what did he do? Why is he famous, right? That's what everybody wants to know. Well, here he was kidnapped in 1765. So he was born July 9th, today, 1760, kidnapped at a at the age of five. And next in history, we find that he's found on a dock in Virginia, June 23rd, 1765. So he's a little boy on a dock, crying. All he could say was his name, was Pedro Francisco. That's all he knew, was Pedro Francisco. He didn't know his last name was Machado Luis. Well, maybe he did or forgot, right? But when he was found, they take him to the local orphanage. And from there, he ends up kind of like a slave in Virginia on a large plantation. In his day, he had a darker, swarthy Mediterranean look. So he didn't fit in with a white Anglo-Saxon family. So he ends up out in the plantation working as a slave. Kind of, sort of. The reason I say maybe, sort of, because there wasn't any paperwork to say he's a slave. So we know that. So, but he grows to be a giant. As he's growing as a little boy, he becomes almost 2 meters tall. So in his day, most men were about this short, you know, that much shorter. So here he is, this tall, huge, and in the U.S., the American Revolution was beginning. And there's a lot of stories that I could tell you about because he was so big, but let me tell you of two. Because George Washington, the first president of the United States, says we would have lost the whole American Revolution without Pedro Francisco, in particular, two battles that he was in. Those two battles most likely were, he was referencing Stony Point, which was north of Manhattan. So if anybody's been to New York City just a little bit further north, was a battle that Pedro Francisco was handpicked by George Washington. 10 men. He wanted 10 of the biggest, the best soldiers. So he goes in the middle of the night and he captures the British flag. Of those 20 men, of the 20 soldiers that were picked, only three of them lived. And Pedro Francisco was one of those three. But he captures the British flag and he took a 9-inch gash in his stomach. He was left for dead. But he survived. God had a plan for his life. So that was one. But the other battle is later in North Carolina, which is where I'm from. As a descendant of Pedro Francisco, I live in North Carolina, and one of the monuments that stands in honor is on the battlefield of Guilford Courthouse. That's in North Carolina, in Greensboro. And there, by this point, the war has been going from 1776, it's now 1780. And in this battle, Peter was so big, he had been complaining the swords were too small. He would say it was kind of like having a little toothpick, because he was a big guy. So they finally, George Washington had a huge sword made for Pedro Francisco, and he uses it in one battle. And that was the battle in North Carolina. And he comes swinging with it. It's a massive sword. And there's a big monument in North Carolina to honor him today for that, for what he did. He kills 11 British. And the monument has 11 stones high. And so you can go see it if you're in the US. But that was the turning point of beating the British. Only 7 months later did they surrender. And the United States of America becomes who they are today because of the help of Peter Francisco. The Luso-American immigrant truly embodies the Peter Francisco's story of courage. So I would say courage is probably the one word you could wrap it up with.
Pela ausência de documentação que comprova a real presença de Pedro Francisco em todas as batalhas que lhe estão associadas, existe uma lenda que se foi avolumando em torno da sua verdadeira história. Porém, os seus feitos levaram a que ele ficasse conhecido por uns como o Gigante da Virgínia, por outros como o Gigante da Revolução ou ainda o Hércules da Virgínia.
Lenda ou história verídica, o importante é que existem histórias que mudam o percurso da humanidade. Testemunhos que inspiram aqueles que atualmente continuam a lutar pelos valores que defendem. E assim terminamos este programa. Um bem-aja a todos e até à próxima.